now we discuss about again globalization and its critics, different aspects of globalization. First is industrial globalization. Today there is a spread of multinational industries at global level, as spread of multinational industries at global level as the industrial list are free to set up their industries anywhere in the world where they find the situation suitable. They don't want to waste their time and money in transportation of raw material, wherever they get cheap raw material and cheap labor, they set up their industrial unit. Wherever they get cheap raw material and cheap labor, they set up their industrial unit at that place. So in these days, developing countries are providing all types of the facilities to the industrialist of developed country to set up industries in their country. As a result of so many industries and multinational companies have installed their industries in African and Asian countries. Now second aspect is financial. Today the world has turned into big financial market, as a result of which loan facility are widely available. It is easy for entrepreneurs to get loan at responsible interest rate, and they can spread their industrial capabilities. In achieving this purpose, the international financial institutions are playing an important role, and the entire world has become big financial market. So money can transfer from one country to another within minutes and seconds through core banking and internet. Next is political aspect. Today, globalization has also become an important tool of established political influence on the weak and underdeveloping nation by rich and powerful nation. The rich and powerful countries, by giving help to poor nation to establish their political influence over them, to which the critics have given the name of political suggestions and new colonialism. The rich countries have their hegemony over the international financial institutions like World Bank, IMF and World Trade Organization, and they make use these according to their wishes. Next is information technology aspects globalization. As a result of widespread of information technology in the world from last 20th century and beginning of 21st century, world has become very small. Any small incident was take place in any corner of the world, spread very fast all over the world. Just example, students, COVID-19, it spread in China. And within second, this news spread whole world. Everywhere you heard about that, such kind of the disease. So, in spread of information, the telephone, satellite, internet, television, radio, newspaper, magazines, etc. have played an important role and have helped in mutual exchange of information among different nations. Today, the doctors, lawyers, engineers, experts in other fields can exchange and share information through video conferencing while sitting in their respective offices, as a result of which they save a lot of money and time only because of information aspect. Now discuss about the culture globalization. In present days of globalization, the culture exchange among different nations has considerably increased. As a result of this, almost in every country of the world, uniculture societies have changed into multicultural societies. पहले क्या होता था, एक तरह का कल्चर होता था, वी कैन से दैट यूनिकल्चर. अब बहुत तरह का कल्चर हो गया है, दैट वॉज कॉल्ड मल्टी कल्चर सोसाइटी. एंड इन स्प्रेड ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, रेडियो, टेलीविजन, इंटरनेट, सेटेलाइट एंड फिल्म बीइंग मेड अप, बॉलीवुड एंड हॉलीवुड एटसेट्रा हैव प्लेड एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल. इन दीज डेज थ्रू सेटेलाइट सो मेनी चैनल्स ऑफ टेलीविजन हैव मिटिगेटेड द डिस्टेंस अमंग डिफरेंट कंट्रीज. कल्चर ट्रूप्स move from one country to another to display culture of their respective countries. As a result of all this, no country can claim of culture purity. Punjabi pop music is very popular in nightclubs of European countries even, you know. And similarly, Western pop music has become the heartbeat of youth in the countries of East, and all this can be called the cultural aspects of globalization. Due to all these things, we can say that it's interlinked with each other. Market globalization. This is the last aspect, students. So most of the political thinkers and Marxists in particular consider globalization of international market, whose purpose to convert an entire world into an open market. To achieve this purpose, restriction on imports and exports have been relaxed. Import and export tariff have been decreased, and proper environment have been created for the free movement of goods from one country to another, and principle of free competition and open trade have been given practical shape. So to conclude, we can say that globalization of industry, finance, information and culture, etc., its scope is very wide. Thanks.